Hi there, Adele Spraggan, the author of Shift, Four Steps to Personal Empowerment, and the creator of Unleash Your Genius and the Repattern for Success programs. And today I would like to talk about money. First of all, let's ask a question. What is it? You know, it used to be way back when that money was actually attached to something. You weren't rich unless you had real estate. And then it was attached to gold. Oh, there's my cat. And then we attached it to currency because gold got too heavy to carry around in our pockets. So we decided, okay, we'll leave the gold in the bank. We'll give everybody promissory notes. They can walk around with those. But if anybody wants to have a look at their gold, they're welcome to walk into the bank and see it because it was all contained there. Then we decided, you know what? Why do we really need the gold? Nobody's actually coming in to look. Let's just walk around with these promissory notes and we'll just pretend that there's money in the bank. And that way everybody, you know, we'll just keep exchanging these promissory notes and that's the way we're gonna go. And so money became attached to currency. And then eventually it was, well, why do we really need currency? Why don't we just use this little bank card? We'll just walk around with that and we'll just pretend that there's currency in the bank. And if anybody wants to come in and see it, they can. And we'll give it to them. But how many people are actually gonna walk in that bank? You know what, we really don't need it. We'll just walk around with this bank card. So money has become a story. It's a story we tell each other about this exchange value and what it's worth and all that. And really in reality, money is just numbers on a page. Now when we really get this, money is a story, a collective story, sure, a shared story, an agreement, but still a story. Then we get to say, what story do we want to write for ourselves when it comes to money? Because there are collective stories like that one. You know, we'll just say that this money is actually in the bank when it isn't. And then there are personal stories. How much am I worth? How much are my services worth? How much can I charge? You know, have you ever wondered why some people, some entrepreneurs, some service providers get to charge like $150,000 for the same value given in the same amount of time that somebody else is only willing to charge $15,000 for, and somebody else $150 for? You see, we have collective stories around money, but then we have personal stories around money. And it's those personal stories that keep us hitting the glass ceiling time and time again. We just don't get past those personal stories to get to the level of wealth and abundance that we deserve. So today I'd like you to question, what are your personal stories? What do you tell yourself about money? What do you tell yourself about what your programs are worth? Here, ask yourself this question. What are rich people to me? Are they greedy or are they charitable? Are they abundant or are they, you know, selfish in some way, holding back, not sharing their wealth? Because how we feel about rich people keeps us trapped inside somebody who is not a rich person, right? Depending on how those personal stories play out. So today I want you to write down everything that you believe about money, whether you've heard it out there in the world or whether you actually accept it for yourself. Money is scarce, money is abundant, money is greedy, money is evil, money is good. All of those stories that we hear and we tell ourselves, they're impacting us. So let's get them all out onto paper so that you can see which ones are working for you and which ones need a little upgrade. Because once we upgrade those stories, then we get to break through those glass ceilings. Now, let me tell you something out there. There's this really funny phenomenon that goes on when it comes to shared stories. If we can seek agreement, then we think to ourselves, oh, then my story must be true. So a lot of people will go out there and seek agreement that people who charge those $150,000 for their programs, they are, audacious, or how dare they, right? Because their patterns are saying, oh boy, I shouldn't be charging that much. So we seek agreement that that's true, that those programs are not worth that much, but they're all just stories. And they're stories that we tell ourselves. So check out your personal stories. Are they working for you or working against you? Then watch out for those cultural stories once you change your personal stories. So once you say, no, like it's really true. I am worth charging $150,000, then watch out because people will try and pull you back down below that glass ceiling, okay? And it's got nothing to do with whether you really are worth that or not. It's got everything to do with that person's stories about money. So write them all down. Now listen, I would like to invite you to join me finding your personal profits in your personal patterns program. It's a brand new program that I just created in 2018, and it's to help us to break free of those patterns, those stories that hold us back. And together, we're gonna break free of this cultural conversation so that we can start a whole new story out there in the world, one that brings you that abundance. If that's something of interest, just check out my website, adelspragan.com. You'll see turning your personal profits into your personal, oh my goodness, I've done it again. Turning your personal patterns into your personal profits program. It's such a mouthful, I can't even get it out. And in there, we are gonna look at all of these different patterns that we have around money and transform them. And I've already started running one program and people are getting amazing results, which I'll tell you about in the near future. But that program's starting real soon. Registration starts March 26th, I believe. So if that's something of interest to you, check it out. I would love to chat with you about it. You can always book a strategy call. Meanwhile, write down all your stories. Let's get those upgraded so you can break through your own personal glass ceiling and create the wealth that you deserve. And I will see you next week.